Hello, Zizo. Horo Zizo. Lord, hello, hello. Kudos. Welcome. Good morning from my end, anyway. Hope you're doing well. Yeah. Everything looks good. Chat is popping up. Yesterday, when we were doing the stream, for some reason, the chat wasn't popping up at first. So I was like, what's going on? We had to do a little restart. 7 p.m. here. Good evening. You gonna have some deep fried pancakes for dinner? Never click so fast on a notification in my life. The QC warrior. Nice. Malik. Hello, Malik. How are you doing? Welcome, welcome. Welcome, welcome. Fun. I liked the two streams yesterday. It was fun doing two streams. It was interesting, definitely interesting. Sort of resetting everything and making sure all the images, everything I wanted off. It was fun. It was fun. Keeps me on my toes, right? Keeps me honest. Hey man, good to see you. Good to see you, Tom. Hey Chicho. Toulouse. There's a lot of U's in that name. Toulouse, that's a cool name. I turned the stream on, Speedy Gonzalez. I loved Speedy Gonzalez, man. Speedy Gonzalez was one cartoon that I would drop everything for to go check out. I don't know why, it was just fun. I like speedsters. I liked one of the first superheroes that I liked was the Flash. So I think that's where my love of speedsters comes in, right? Not to mention sports and stuff. Hello, Red Robin. How are you doing? Hope you liked the stream yesterday. It was fun. Or two streams yesterday. They were fun. They were definitely fun. So again, we're going to give everybody a little time to tune in. Double Elvis. Hello, hello. How are you doing? Yes, my favorite TV chef is back. We're going to make some deep fried pancakes. Fun. No, what Speedy Gonzalez has under his gapers? Under. That's awesome. I've never heard that one before. The joke is, the question is, know what Speedy Gonzalez has under his carpet. I read cape. Underlay. Ha ha. Lord is laughing. Hey Chicho. Hello Frank. How are you doing? Welcome to a cooking stream. Fun. Cool. So before everyone shows up, we're giving people enough time to show up. No matter how many people show up, we're gonna make ourselves some pancakes. Let me give you a lay of the land. Same as before. Mic, camera. We got two cameras pointing at the stovetops. Boop. Video, right? So what we're gonna do, I got my coconut oil in here already. So might as well start this up already. Action. So action, let's take down the "we'll start shortly" sign. These "start shortlys" are coming up faster and faster, right? Start shortly. They come for the pancakes, they stay for the Socratic method. I'm assuming that's Socrates. Spinoff Socrates. Socratic method. I gotta look that up. I'm learning a lot from these streams. It's fantastic. Hey Chicho, time for round three. Yeah, round three, day two. Hi Sam, how are you doing? Welcome. So basically what we're gonna do here, let me turn this up, and I'm just gonna use one of the elements, the small element, right? That's all we need, not too much. And I'm gonna put this on about 4.5, 5. I'm putting it on 5 so it heats up fast, and you know, we get the oil hot enough, and then we're gonna kick it up a notch with the heat, right? We're gonna mix our stuff here and have eats here and do different things here, okay? And the name of the game is, Morning, case man. How are you doing? Good morning, good morning. And let me turn these off, the two cameras off for now. Okay. And basically what we're doing in this video, we're going to talk about philosophy. And basically we're following up, because that's only 6 minutes for the intro. We'll bring it up again if people want to find out what we're talking about, if they're coming in, right? Yeah, slowly picking up. Usually I want to wait about 10 minutes to do this thing. But let's check this out. We got da da da. Let me show you the recipe, because the recipe we can go over. And then I'll give the intro for the philosophy stuff, what the discussion is, what we're gonna do, just continuation from the previous video, right? Saturday and I got nothing to do. Uninterrupted chicho. Right on, Robin. Fun. It's a nice Saturday. We actually just had a storm pass through. We had some thunder. Like 15 minutes ago, there was thunder here. It was dark, and slowly the clouds are parting. I don't know if just the gap in the front. So just a heads up, there was thunder. So if there's lightning, if I end up losing power, we lost power. I'll come up when if power restores, and it will restore fast, but just a heads up, if we lose power, we lose the connection, and if it's a lot later, then we'll just go on with the comic book stuff at 3:30, right? But basically what we're gonna do today is make our family, we call it our, within ourselves, we call it our Armenian donuts, right? And it's basically just a little bit modified version of the pancakes recipe we had in the previous video. We made philosophy and pancakes, right? So this is the recipe. Basically, we're gonna use 1.5 cups of whole wheat flour, 1.5 cups of white flour, and I've mainly been using 3 cups of wheat flour, but I want to mix it up with white flour a little bit. I want to start experimenting, getting to some of the pastries I know how to make. I've made a lot, and they all require white flour, because pastries with whole wheat, they don't puff up. You need the white flour for it to puff up a fair bit. Okay, we're gonna use a little bit of baking soda as before, egg optional, and we're gonna do our yogurt water mix for the liquid going into the dry stuff. Okay, I'm writing a paper all afternoon, so Chicho's philosophical monologues will keep me company. Also, man, you do a lot of work, Tom. That's a serious master's degree, I believe you said, right? Ah, papers, I remember those. What's the subject? The Egyptian Revolution and the Syrian Civil War, basically contending that neither were the result of people tweeting, which is a concerning position in academia at the moment. Oh, they're actually thinking that some of these revolutions and civil wars and proxy wars and stuff is because of people tweeting? I hope not. I hope not. I have a book. I hope you're taking the opposite of that view. Basically, contending, yeah. Contending, I don't know, maybe. I have a book all about that, as relates to social movements are arguing the other side. Wow, man, I'd like to read that paper. So the coconut is melting nicely, so I'm gonna leave it at 5. Okay, so that's our recipe. Now that we're a little bit deeper in, it's about 10 minutes in, so let's go through our little intro about philosophy, right? Let me take down the recipe here. For sure, there's a lot of academics that think social media is 100% responsible for them. Don't get me wrong, they play a function in them, but they're certainly not catalysts. Yeah, I agree with you. They play a role, for sure, in my opinion as well, of propagating propaganda. Whoever controls the media controls the narrative, right? And there's a lot of centralization. So yeah, I agree. Crazy. Academia is weird, weird. It wouldn't be the most mad way a war, revolution, or uprising had started, to be fair. No, a symptom of a existing social movement instead of catalyst. I can see that. Cool. Cool. I love this discussion. So let's lay down the foundation of what we're going to talk about, what this is, these videos, and we're going to do more of these, right? My thing is, just sitting down and talking philosophy is fantastic, but I think we need to be doing something when we're talking philosophy. So right now we're doing cooking recipes and stuff like this because I'm really enjoying this, and I have a lot of recipes to go through, and it's giving me a chance to experiment. But we'll do other things and talk philosophy. One of the things I do need to do is, springtime coming in, definitely need to fix up the patio with the plants. So for sure we're gonna do plant care, philosophy and plant care, as soon as the weather heats up a little bit. So we'll go on the patio and do another live stream with philosophy and plant care, and do other things as well, right? If I ever got a master's, it would be in sociology. I love it. Yeah, I would love to do linguistics personally. I would love to do linguistics. So here's our here's the previous video we did, okay? And this was basically, looked up the definition of philosophy, and we'll go through that, and we sort of put out this video saying that we made pancakes and we talked about philosophy, right? And basically the working definition of philosophy was this that we used, and this is something I took off Wiki. The triple dots or four dots basically means continuation of cut things up, right? But basically it's our working definition, and that is in flux, right? And this doesn't mean that I take Wikipedia to be the end all or be all of everything, right? It's just a place to begin the discussion, right? And we read this thing, and what I'm going to do, I'm going to read this thing again, but we sort of set the mood or sort of the foundation, what we're going to do in these streams when it comes to talking philosophy and whatever else that we're doing, which is basically, we talked a fair bit about it in this video, and this is the working definition that we're going with. So let me take down the video. I'm just going to read a couple more comments. You got it. That's my take on it. At least I can absolutely see how they're used for coordination, a spreading of information and disinformation. But I think that's the limit of its effect on something as significant as regime change. And I only really recommend an MA in sociology. Fascinating stuff. Oh, really? Masters. MA is masters, I'm assuming. That's the symbol used for it. So let's read our definition of philosophy. Okay. Just for those that the screen might be a little bit too small to read and who didn't participate in the previous stream, right? So our working definition of philosophy is the following, and this is sort of segments taken from Wikipedia. And again, this is in flux. This is not the end all or be all, but it's a good opening point, right? So philosophy, philosophia, literally love of wisdom, is the study of general and fundamental problems concerning matters such as existence, knowledge, values, reason, mind, and language. Historically, philosophy encompasses any body of knowledge, including astronomy, medicine, and physics. In the modern era, some investigations that were traditionally part of philosophy became separate academic disciplines, including psychology, sociology, linguistics, and economics. Many of those who study philosophy in undergraduate or graduate programs contribute in the fields of law, journalism, politics, religion, science, business, and various art and entertainment activities, right? And again, that's sort of quoting Wikipedia, and who knows if that's still the same text on Wiki or not. I grabbed this when we did our first video, right? That's our working definition, and to me, I take that as being open discussion. Anything goes, okay? That's what that means to me, because if philosophy is going to contribute to all these fields, from economics, politics, science, and you know, there's information about philosophy relating to mathematics, anything goes, okay? And while we talk about that stuff, we're going to make pancakes, or we're going to make deep-fried pancakes, or Armenian pancakes, the way we refer to it. And there's another name that we refer to it, actually, which is called, it's a Russian word, it's called oladishki. Okay, so the The elders, right? The ancient ones in the previous stream were talking about the food, right? Taking the recipe of the ancient ones and modifying it, right? They call this aladishki, but as we've seen, as I happens with me, I take recipes and change them according to my taste and how I like them. Sometimes they're a success, sometimes they're not, right? Sometimes the recipe needs more modification. Like the macarons, I've modified the ancients' recipes. And we added chocolate chips, add a little bit of this. It came out really good. It's better than the original recipe. But the raisin cookies we made yesterday, they didn't come out too good. I gotta try that again. I gotta go back to the original recipe because this is like the third modification I tried for it, right? So I'm gonna go back to the original recipe and start up again, right? Which is something that sometimes we tend to do. If things are going wrong, just don't continue down that path. Go back to the beginning, right? And that goes in life as well. Cooking is huge, reflected in life, right? It's an amazing reflection of life. You can feel my tummy growling. My tummy's hungry for deep fried pancakes. But basically, sometimes you have to go back and rethink from your original thought, your original recipe, and then go in a certain direction, right? So I'm just gonna read comments and work on this. Our oil's nice and hot, so I'm just gonna leave it at 5, or maybe I'm just gonna kick it down to 3 until we get the dough ready. One topic I would love to discuss with you is the way you observe life. Optimistic, pessimistic, etc. Sure. If you remind me, I'm just gonna start this up, and then once we start doing things, I can give you my opinion on optimism, pessimism. For sure. Remember that philosophy, and that was Lord and Malik saying, remember that philosophy, philo love, sophy. Knowledge, wisdom is the enemy of sophistry. Sophistry, I don't know what sophistry. The philosopher loves knowledge. The sophist believes he or she represents knowledge. Oh, okay. Philosophy, let me read that again. The philosopher loves knowledge. The sophist believes he or she represents knowledge, which is represented in how the names of those philosophical schools came about. Philosopher is a lover of wisdom. Sophist is the wise. Oh, wow. I didn't know that. That's cool. I would love to study linguistics, really. Sophistry, the use of fallacious argument. Fallacious argument, not fallacious. Okay. I'm going to put on my glasses for certain things. The use of fallacious arguments, especially with the intention of deceiving. Ah, the wise tend to try to deceive, right? So let's bring up our recipe. Dun, Armenian recipe. Open up. And I'm just gonna do our camera views as well. Okay, we don't need this guy right now. It's philosophy. Glasses are required. So basically, 1.5 cups of whole wheat flour, 1.5 cups of white flour. So here's my whole wheat flour. Okay. There's a little bit less than. How am I gonna get this? There we go. A little bit less than 1 cup. So I'm gonna keep that in mind. And that's a little bit more than half a cup. So that's 1.5 cups of whole wheat flour. Let's put this guy here. We don't need this guy right now anymore. Clear up our workspace a little bit as we're going with this. Here's my white flour, right? You can see the difference, the color difference a little bit. The whole wheat flour has looks like flakes in it, right? So here's 1 cup. I'll put it on the side. Maybe it'll come out in the light. You can see a little bit. And here is half a cup. Let me decrease it a little bit. Here's half a cup of white flour. Right? Let's put this guy. So that's 1.5 cups of whole wheat, 1.5 cups of wheat. We need a quarter teaspoon of baking soda. I label my glass jars. Some people in the past, sometimes they labeled it on the lid, and on the lid is not the best place to label things because your lid changes, right? So a while ago, here's not that much baking soda. A while ago, I labeled glasses, not the lids anymore. I don't know whose this one is from, actually. Let's put this guy here. And then we got the yogurt and the water mix and the egg. Now, before I do that, I'm going to mix this up. Okay, just mix up the dry stuff so because it's easier for it to mix before the liquid goes in, so you get better distribution. Case man is correct. Sophistry is a method in which a person acts as a impresario, appearing to have absolute knowledge in a subject where in fact they only know enough to appear wise. That's like a lot of the way the cults begin, right? And actually, on that note, I've been watching I watched the first two episodes of the Osho documentary that just came out. It's called Wild Wild Land, I believe. The first, and I read up on Osho a long time ago, right? There's some, you know, a lot of good truth in there, but then there's a lot of cult stuff in there, right? But and there's a lot of politics in there, a lot of economics in there. You know, he was taken out, basically. His philosophy did not agree with the status quo to a certain degree, but that documentary is really good. The philosophical school in Greece, I'm just gonna catch up on the text before we subject where in fact they only appear to be wise. The philosophical school in Greece called the Sophists were, so is, are Sufis from Sophists? Is that where the word, or Sophist, maybe Sophist comes from the word Sufi? Are they related? Sophists were partly responsible for Socrates, maybe that's where it's from, execution by hemlock. Oh, really? Oh, because the other wise men didn't like what Socrates was saying. They're also the inventors of rhetoric. Oh, really? I used to teach it in academia. Rhetoric being a way of communicating persuasively and convincingly in form, the basis for all modern politics. But the Sophist argument was that you should defend your view. Socrates' philosophy was about debating, discussing openly to try to find the correct view or a dissonance in which it is agreed that there is no absolutely correct view, and it is a matter of opinion. So that goes into Robert Anton Wilson's maybe logic, where there are no is's, right? And we're going to use is's, and in mathematics I say to use a lot of is's, but it's all maybes, right? Hello Index, how are you doing? Welcome back. It's like the Sufi and Sophist is linked, as Sophist comes from a Greek word that means teacher. Okay, cool. So the teacher is a connection. Sufi, I believe, implies teacher as well. I don't know a lot of this. Really interesting. Thanks for sharing. Yeah, thanks everyone for sharing this information. I didn't know, like, the word connections are brilliant. I read 3 to 4 Osho books back around 2004, 2005. Very interesting take on Eastern thought, all about meditation, and there was somewhat a materialistic aspect to it as well. Chicho, have you read any Foucault? Someone else mentioned this as well. Who was it? While we're doing this, Foucault, he's the French philosopher, I believe, right? Is that the French philosopher that we're talking about? So I'm gonna crack open an egg, and the egg is optional, okay? So let me do this here, because I'm gonna drop the eggshell in the sink. And after touching eggs, you got it, Michel Foucault. Yeah, you know what, initially I thought I hadn't read of stuff, but then someone mentioned and I read a couple of things, and I've read a little bit of just excerpts. I've never read a book. I believe I've watched some of his videos because he looked familiar, and or debates or something like this. Oh, long time ago, long time ago. You have to remember that so much of our symbology, both religious and political, as well as our linguistic, goes all the way back to ancient Greek and the Greek philosophers. So that in what do we need? Oh, we need a cup. And I think it goes back the linguistics. I mean, I realized linguistics was really important from Chomsky. You got it, Michel Fanon. Okay, he's indeed the constructionist responsible for genealogical approach to history. I wonder how he's related to Graham Hancock. Graham Hancock's gone back and dug up some. He comes out and says most of human history that we know is not legit, right? I find this stuff a little difficult to follow as it's all translated from French, but it's fascinating once you crack what he's saying. And that's Foucault. Oh, Foucault. Foucault. Michel Foucault. He's saying his book Discipline and Punish is fascinating. Discipline and Punish. So I'm just gonna do this on the side. I'm gonna take 1.5 cups of yogurt, okay, and we're gonna put it in a bowl. Where's my bowl? Oh, I didn't put out the bowl. I gotta put out the bowl. So I'm gonna put it in this, and we're gonna mix it up with water, okay? And then after that, we're just gonna throw everything in and mix it all up here, right? So I'm just gonna take down the recipe, and I'm gonna get this going, and that way we can start the cooking process, right? So I'm gonna kick this down. I'm gonna leave this open. Okay, I'm gonna move it over a little bit because usually I don't leave it on 4 or 5 this long. I usually get it done, start cooking right away, right? So we need a bowl to mix the stuff in. Oh, there. Oh no, we're not gonna. I could use that. Yeah, let's use this. This thing I've got on the side here where we're gonna make the donuts and put it in there. So I'm just gonna mix my. Ooh, that's gonna be loud for the mic. Sorry about that. I'm gonna mix my yogurt and stuff in here. Can actually do this here. Let me show it to you. Let's put this here. That way you see what I'm doing. Turn down the heat on this. So I'm going to take 1.5 cups of yogurt. And this is last time we used 3% yogurt or 3.5%. This one is 2.5. Okay. So I'm taking, that's one bowl. Right. Just throw it in here. I might add more later. I want the dough to be thick, thicker than what we have for the pancakes. And let's do it. And yogurt is absolutely amazing. It's good for the tummy. Yogurt is amazing for the tummy, right? So there is 1.5 of yogurt. And I'm gonna mix water. So we're gonna put in 1.5 cups of water. And I might do it a little more as well. We'll see. Once I mix it in with the dough, we'll have a good feel for it. I know the texture we're looking for. Actually, I might make it too. Closer to 2 then. Let me put this guy. Oh, let me put it in this. Because we might need that again. Put a little cup on that, right? So let's mix this up. Linguistics was really important for one of my favorite philosophers, Wittgenstein. I don't know him, I don't think so. Good shout. Let me go back. I lost a little bit. Oddly enough, Foucault was as a critic of Sophia's. I find this stuff. His book Discipline, oddly enough, critic of Soviet philosophy. I know, that's why I bought him up. Okay, cool. Linguistics is really important. Linguistics was really important for one of my favorite philosophers. What is that name? Wittgenstein. I don't know that. A good shout. He's a much easier read in French if you know the language. Yeah, the language translation is difficult from one language. Not read Discipline and Punishment for a long time. That might be must read for me. So let's mix this in. Okay, so I'm gonna throw this in. Yeah, I don't think we need this one, but we're gonna keep it. And we're gonna mix this guy up. Okay, I'm gonna bring up the recipe just to make sure we didn't lose anything. Forgot to put something that needs to be in there. So we got our whole wheat flour, we got our white flour, we got our baking soda, we got our egg in there. 1 to 1 cup of yogurt, mix it with 1 to 1 cup of water, and we do. And that's it. I'm gonna deep fry in coconut oil. Okay, so I'm gonna mix this, and I just need the texture now, right? So I might adjust it a little bit. So to come back on the topic of how we view the world, the popular example, glass half full or glass half empty. I'd love to hear your opinion about it. Okay. Would say that it is a matter for the individual to decide on the state of the glass. Sartre would say that it doesn't matter, as the glass will eventually break. I guess so, the analogy, that's funny. Return into a roach. The glass could, according to quantum mechanics, right? Anything could be anything, I guess, if that's what you're referring to. Walt isn't that Kafka. You know what, I've never read Kafka. I don't know. I don't know if there's such a thing reading Kafka. Kafka would say that the glass is full of something and nothing. It was like Schrodinger's cat, right? As far as my take on optimism and pessimism, I mean, where do we begin, right? For me, now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna add a little bit more flour to this. The texture is too loose. If it's too loose, we put it in the coconut oil. If we put it in the oil, it's gonna break up too much. Okay, so I'm gonna kick this up again to 4. We're almost ready. I'm just gonna add some flour, and I'll answer the question. I'm gonna put in white flour. Okay, so I'm gonna put in about 1/4 cup more. And I'll give you my take about optimism and pessimism as soon as we get this stuff going. Let me read a couple of more things. It's maybe a weird source, but the Walking Dead TV show has a good quote on this. The pessimist looks down and hits his head. The optimist looks up and loses his footing. The realist looks forward and adjusts his path accordingly. Okay, since you brought out realists, and the other ones, the other two were the optimist and the pessimist, the example I use for this is, in that category, the thought process I would go would be Che Guevara and Fidel Castro. Okay, Che was an idealist, so I would put pessimist and optimist in that category, right? He was an idealist. He was a dreamer. He thought, I'm just adding a little bit more, about 1/8 more, just to make it a little bit thicker, right? He couldn't accept the fact that they couldn't bring the revolution to the world instantly. Fidel Castro was the realist. They got a victory, and he realized that it was time to bunker down and really fortify their position. So that was the big difference between Fidel Castro and Che Guevara in regards to optimist and pessimist, right? Fidel was happy with what they got. Fidel was ecstatic with what they got, right? Che wasn't satisfied. So that would be something that I could, you know, reference the way I look at optimist and pessimist. And the philosopher, and the philosopher stirs the pot. My personal take is that there is a place for everything at the table. An optimist gives you the enthusiasm to push on through turbulent times. The pessimist gives you the analysis of fault that allows you to find flaws in any function. The realist sees the benefits of both and how to apply them across the full range of any subject. He's laughing. Kind of like Marx versus Lenin. Is that in regards to Fidel and Che? So this is heating up, right? And we're not going to use the lid again. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take this big spoon I got. I'm just going to throw some in there. And I want it to sizzle when I'm throwing it in there. So we'll see where this stands. Let me turn on that. We need the camera on here. So we're hitting up the oil now. Let's hit up the oil. And you got to be careful with oil. Okay. So I'm going to take about this much. Let's throw that in. And usually on the first one, I put one a little bit to one side. And this one I'm going to put to one side as well. Okay. Now let's see how that comes out. I'm going to turn the heat down a little bit. Okay. I'm going to put my fork in here. You don't need to mix anymore. Right now, anyway. I'm going to put in a little plate here. That way, if we need it, we got it. We're not making a mess everywhere. I agree with you that a realist is pretty much both an optimist and a pessimist. Is one of the other when it's according. According, as long as they're smart enough. Some realists refuse to change their ways. Or realists don't take action when they need to take action. I think you need the optimist and the pessimist or the idealist to counterbalance the realist. That's why Che and Fidel were able to do what they were able to do together, and with a lot of other people as well. It was a big group of people that did it, right? Indeed. Like anything, they're both extremes. So I'm gonna do this. So as soon as this goes in a little bit, I take a little fork, right? And I just hit the bottom, and this needs to cook, right? And I'm gonna bring another little plate. And the fork we're gonna use, this guy, I'm just gonna put in another plate, right? Just hold it there. That way everything is its own place. We're not mixing everything up. Because I got a few different things I wanna try. I've only made this with just deep frying this thing. Actually, I'm gonna kick it up now to around the 7. Because I do want this, actually around the 6, I'm kicking up the temperature, okay? I've only made this just with the dough, but I got some ingredients, and I have a little bowl here. What I like to do is mix like chocolates and raisins and little things and throw those in there and make like the way we did with the pancakes, right? It's a classic problem with the Marx philosophy. I'm thankful, so I'm happy about her. Let's check it out. Indeed, like anything, they're both extremes. And I think the majority of people realistically fall somewhere between. Example, literally 3 hours ago, my partner was in a car. Oh, what? She's okay. But her car is probably totaled. Oh, wow. I'm sorry to hear that, case man. But she walked away. If the car is totaled and she walked away, she's going to have pain. I've been in some pretty major car accidents. Very important to get some physiotherapy right away. She might feel it tomorrow. Where are we? So I'm happy about her, sad about the car and money it will take to fix it. Yeah, but the health thing is huge. If she's okay, that's huge. And thankful for the reminder that everything can change in an instant. So be thankful. Yeah, that's lessons I've learned as well over time. That be thankful for what we have, right? You don't know when it's gonna flip on you. Send my best to your girlfriend, Case Man. If you guys were close, I'd make you Armenian donuts and bring them to you, right? It's the classic problem with Marx philosophy. Marx's theme were very worthwhile, and his criticism of modern life well worth considering. Lenin's application of that philosophy was beset with narrow vision and overt idealism, not to mention the fact that he was unable to accept that his adherence to parts of Marxist philosophy had any flaws in reality. I agree with you there, Malik, but one other thing regarding Lenin, Marxism, communism, USSR, and stuff like this, just like our political systems here, actually not just like them, right now in the Western world anyway, majority of the people that we see talking, representing the country are just puppets. They're, in my opinion anyway, right? As Bill Hicks would say, in the United States, whoever gets elected, they take him down into, or is it George Carlin, they take him down, you know, they welcome him in the White House, take him down to the basement floor, sit him down, put on a video showing the assassination of JFK, and then, you know, the lights go off, and the assassin of JFK showing angles that we've never seen before. Lights go off and a couple of men come on in the front and they say, any questions, right? So that's the thing here. In the past, I think the leaders had more control, but there were a lot of people that were involved with the atrocities that took place during those periods. So the philosophy got hijacked in a big way, which I think Lenin did as well, but there was other people involved in this, many, many other people involved in this. A realistic, this is just my opinion, by the way, right? I don't want to be too absolute with everything I say. Please challenge me, give me more info, that'd be fantastic. A realist will take risks, example, when he sees it will work. An idealist will take risks faster and have more chance to fail. Yeah, the realists will take risk, and they need the idealist to give them information. So ideally, I guess, no pun intended, you want a realist, if you're going to do with a centralized system, you want a realist to be getting information from idealists. And as long as the realist is getting good information and it's not being filtered away, then decisions can be made. But right now that doesn't exist in our, if we're just talking about political system or even economic system, that doesn't exist, which I think is one of the reasons we need any education system, any centralized system, that doesn't exist anymore, right? It doesn't. So X, how are you doing? Welcome, welcome. So that's one thing I believe it needs to happen is, with an open community, is idealist and realist and pessimists and optimists have to get together and present ideas and argument and discuss. No secrecy in terms of ideas. Just my take. Hope everything works out, Matt, mate. Yeah, hope everything works out, Case Man. Really. How are you? I've been in car accidents, so if you need some advice, if things are depending on how she got hit, send me a message. I'll let you know what I've done to come out of, get back on my feet to a certain degree as best as possible, right? Absolutely, but it's always the place. Case Man, thanks, friends. Our pleasure, man. Absolutely, but it's always the place where collectivism, philosophy, Case Man, just one more note. I don't know how it works where you guys are, if you guys have insurance and stuff like this, health insurance or car insurance or accident insurance. If your insurance company, just piece of advice, if your insurance company comes up and offers you money more than you think, that, you know, you're happy to receive that money, you're in need of money, if they offer you money right away, don't settle. If you have insurance, don't settle even months or years down until you see what the effects of the accident are. Okay, so first bit of advice is not even health related, it's economics related. If your insurance company comes and writes you a check and says settle with us, don't settle with them. In my area, that's the way it works, because they're not, your health comes first, so you have to wait. Time allows you to figure out what you might be, what the health effects of the accident could be. Absolutely, it's always a place where collectivist philosophy falls down. The fact that, you know what, mob mentality falls down. I don't think we've had collectivist philosophy. We've had gatekeepers throughout society. I think this is, if we play the cards right, we have the opportunity to have true representation in science, in education, in health, in medicine, in politics, in economics. We have that opportunity. The gatekeepers are trying to prevent that. But we have, for the first time in history, human history, as far as we know, as far as Graham Hancock would disagree, right? And I agree with Graham Hancock. There's a lot of things that happen in humanity's history that we are completely unaware of, period. And again, Robert Anton Wilson, coming out of Dark Ages, people are individuals and have individual needs, for sure. That's why liberty is the most important thing that we need to preserve in a collective society. Liberty number one, right? Liberty number one, and you can't have liberty without privacy, right? So sharing of information and stuff, but you need, there has to be fail-safe mechanisms put in there, so the mob mentality doesn't take over, right? People are individuals, therefore they do not always think of a collective of humans or a system, community, social, society, as they would themselves at present. As far as we know, Graham Hancock has talked a fair bit about this, and I know there's these different types of philosophies available throughout history from different cultures that tell us there were collective societies where individual liberty was preserved and people made decisions collectively. We don't have that right now. We don't have it. There might be pockets of it, but we don't have it in our country's political systems. That's my take on it. I'm getting to X's gap. I say, this is a socialist myself. I think most contemporary philosophers believe that Socrates had it right in the beginning. You need everyone around the table to make the best decisions rather than trusting a narrow view. Agreed. And I think technology will allow us to do that. I highly recommend Republic. I've been meaning to read Republic by Plato. I've been meaning to read it. I haven't read it yet. Check this out. Oop. Definitely don't want any splatter in this. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to put this here. I don't need to give this a rinse. Okay, so let me show you this. This is basically, you know, this that I have and a bowl that I'm going to put it in. And the donuts, I'm just going to, when they're ready, I'm going to take them in and put them in here so they drip whatever oil is on top to the bottom of the bowl. There isn't that much. It's pretty easy way to do this. Okay. So just to let you know, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to use this bowl to make different things. So my question to you is, I'm going to make two of these guys right now. I got a couple of things I have here, right? We can definitely make some raisins. I've never done this before. I only make the dough. Okay. But since we're doing this talking philosophy, why not, right? I got raisins. Maybe throw it in there, mix in a dough, make raisin donut. Got coconuts, and they're going to be, they're not sweet. Dough is not sweet. So I'm going to use maple syrup, and I got jams and stuff here, right? We got coconut, and I got chocolate chips as well. Okay. So the first one, you know what? Let's do with a little bit of coconut. So I put in this much coconut. Okay. Just so you see. And I'm going to mix in dough, and we're going to make it And I'm going to take the same amount, actually a little bit more. All right, let me put this over here. Do a little bit more. All right, put it in there. I might have put a little bit too much coconut, so you know what? Let's put enough so we make two. Okay. I should be showing you this. So we're going to take this. I'm going to take my fork and let's mix this up. So we'll make two at a time. Sound good? And I can make, in this thing, I can make three at a time. As you can see, I have enough room to put another donut there. But we'll go two at a time right now and then maybe do three at a time. Okay. And I'm going to bring in another, because I don't want to mix whatever we're contaminating the dough with the main dough thing. So I'm going to bring in another one. Right, and we're gonna leave it this in here because that's the one we're gonna use. Right, let me take this lid and put it over here, make room for ourselves. Right, we have a sip of tea. I missed out on a few comments doing this stuff, but let's see. Republic, very true, optimist, neat, pessimist, and vice versa. Just like ideal need light, just like my cat needs his dinner. Awesome, I agree. So let's see this. Let's check this out. So this is good. Take a look. I don't want to do that. Oop, that's loud. Let me put this guy here. Let me show you what this looks like. Right. So I'm gonna put this in the screen, right? Actually, let's do this way. Okay, let me show you. So basically, this is what we got, right? Let me bring it over, that's fine. So I just put it in here, and I'm gonna put it in the bowl so it drip dries, right? Now what we're gonna do is, we're gonna put the coconut. We're gonna make two of these guys. Hot oil is dangerous. You can make little guys as well, right? So, let me bring a... this guy. So all I'm gonna do is gonna, the little guys would just be crispier, right? Let's put this guy here. Now let's get the other one ready, right? So for the next one, shall we make chocolate? Let's make raisin on this one. Okay, so I put this guy here. And then we'll do chocolate, because the chocolate might melt into the oil, right? Let's do that. Yeah, let's do a little bit more. And then we'll have one of the donuts, okay? Let's take this, right? I'm going to take this much. Mix it in. Let's mix this guy up. After mixing it up, I'll know if it's enough raisins, right? As long as you can see the raisins. Yeah, check it out. So you can see the raisins, that's not bad. Okay, that's good. Let's do this. Let's take the raisin. So that one's ready. Alright. Let's put our spoon in there. Let's put the raisin on the side. And let's put this on the side. Let's have some of the donuts. Let's bring this guy over. I agree. I missed a lot of conversations, so let's check this out. But we gotta try the donuts, right? Let's put this in. Whoop. So definitely gonna have extra donuts laying around, right? Let's make sure this guy's. Oh, this guy looks good. Look at that. The coconut is giving a nice brownish look. Cool, cool, cool. Let me cut this open. Okay. Take a look. Crispy, right? You can see it's steaming, right? See it's steaming? Popping this in the mouth would be dangerous, right? So you can taste it itself. It just tastes like dough. And these are very much like, if you've ever had Chinese donuts, if you've ever had congee is a rice soup dish that I believe is Mandarin Cantonese. I don't know if it's mainland or Hong Kong. I think in both, but I know people from Hong Kong have this a lot. It's congee, it's like soup, and they have different types of ingredients in there. You could just have rice soup, you can have rice with mushroom soup, rice and prawns, right? Rice, prawns, mushroom. It's just basically a soup, but the broth happens to be rice dish. And when you get that, you can put hot sauce. It's very bland, but you can put hot sauce and stuff in there. And what you do with this, you use these types of donuts and you dip it in and you eat it with the soup. It's very delicious, right? So it tastes very much like that. Very much like that. But I'm gonna have mine with maple syrup, right? We're gonna have this one with maple syrup. With honey, this is amazing. Okay, but the first one we'll do with maple syrup. I bring out cheese from the fridge as well. This is really good with cheese. But since we're going to be making a lot of donuts, I don't want to fill myself up with cheese, right? Usually I wouldn't be making this much for myself, right? So I'm going to refrain from putting some of the other things that I usually put on my Armenian donuts, deep fried pancakes, because I'll fill up too fast. I like to experiment with this and sample all the different types of pancakes. This is delicious. Look, it sucks up the sweets very well. Took that one down fast. Fantastic crunch to it. So. I think this batter would be really good for chicken as well, but I haven't done with it. Only done this with for breakfast sweets. One thing I need to do, I need to find myself a bowl. And not be too loud with it. And I'm going to put the donuts that are done in this bowl here. Okay. And we'll put this guy here. Because I can't eat two of the same ones. That would be too much. That would be way too much. Let's flip this. Look at that. That looks great. Sorry if I'm missing conversation, but the donuts call, right? Let me check this out. There's a lot of discussion going on. Very true, optimist. Da, da, da. Just like idealists need realist. Just like my cat, da 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 da, haha. I agree. If they offered you money, they are trying to save themselves first, and you would be owned much more than they are offering. You need to get an attorney as well. Yeah, and that's Corbin replying to Casey regarding the accident. If they offer you money right away, even a year later, don't do it. Our physical bodies, when they take a hit, psychological and physical, nervous, whatever it is, if you take a hit, it takes a while for the effects of that hit to show themselves. And if you need to adjust your lifestyle because of that hit, that's going to take a long time. So you can't really settle before you realize where you are, where life has directed you. Very important, Casey. Thank you, Corbin, Chicho. That would extend is reasonable to protect that library in your opinion. To what extent is reasonable to protect that liberty in you? Oh, okay, liberty in that. You don't have to answer by any means. Just curious. So, to what extent is reasonable to protect the liberty in your opinion? So, when it comes to, in like for example, just to give you an example, in if we go sci-fi for a second, right? In Star Trek, Vulcans say that the need of the many is more important than the need of the few. And I don't think I'm using the right word that Spock uses or Vulcans use, right? So Vulcans say that the need of the many supersede the need of the one, I believe. That's the saying. I don't agree with that. I don't agree with that at all. Right? Well, we had a little bit of oil spillage. And oil smokes if it's burning too much, right? This here. So, on that level, I don't agree that the need of the many supersedes the need of the... Let me give this a little wipe. I want the oil to be burning on the side here. So to read your question again, liberty. So just to extend that a little further, personal liberty has to be protected. Because once you go down the path of, and this is what the raisins are putting in. Raisins might be dangerous because there's water in the raisins. Hopefully it's not going to pop. Buzzing or sizzling. Because once you start taking away people's liberty, what happens is you're giving certain types of people more power over other people. And automatically, right away, you're gonna start attracting those who seek power. And once you start attracting those who seek power, this is the coconut. Once you start attracting those who seek power, into putting them in positions of power, then you have serious problems, the way we've seen happen right now in our society, where we've given up all our liberties. So for the short term, it might work out okay, but in the long run, it's going to be devastating for society. So liberty, private liberty, has to be protected at all costs, okay? But when it comes to public officials, public decisions, public, I mean, government, right? We can get into the government aspect of things, but I'd rather not go down that route. But those in control of other people, let's leave it at that, those who have been chosen by the collective to govern other people, okay, those people in power has to be complete transparency, okay? Their finances, who they associate with, because they have been given a tremendous amount of responsibility to look after the well-being of a community. And if everything is hidden everything that they do is hidden. Then they can do, if you, I mean, how many people have you interacted with that ended up being not the type of person you thought they were, right? That happens in these types of situations. And if one of those people gets in the position of power, they will seek more power, they will go more secret, and they will seek to take away your liberty, the collective liberty, and protect themselves from all the crimes that they're committing. So if anybody is in control, is responsible for governing other people, then they have to have complete transparency. And on that note, if they are found, not by pointing fingers and, you know, finding a scapegoat and, you know, these people who are in power throwing one of their own to the wolves and stuff like this, right? If it is undeniable that someone in power has committed crimes, abused their power, and hurt other people, then the punishment for them should be way more severe than if someone that wasn't in that position committed the same crime, right? So, for example, when it comes to policing, right? I have my own opinions about policing, but just policing is one example. A lot of police officers, when they commit crimes, and there's a lot of police officers that commit crimes, look at Baltimore, just one example, right? There's a lot of police officers that commit crimes. For example, in the G20 summit, there were agent provocateurs, right? There were police officers dressed up as anarchists, right? Anarchists. They weren't really anarchists. They dressed up as protesters, right? They put on masks, they covered their faces, right? They grabbed rocks, and it was a family event, right? They grabbed rocks and they were trying to start a riot where it was a peaceful protesting the G20 summit, right? And they were trying to start a riot. There were kids there, right? They were caught, they were outed, and the police force protected them. They took them out, and it only came out afterwards that they were police officers trying to start a riot, right? And then if we found out that the word came down from the top management of the police force to do this, right? Absolutely nothing of significance happened to any of those police officers or the people that gave those orders. That to me is horrendous. That to me is the opposite of a democracy. That to me is, if democracy, whatever it is, that to me is, it's the perfect example I have of where we are as a society, where those in power are committing horrendous crimes that could devastate people's lives. And when they're caught, they're not held accountable. That means their clan can continue to do the same thing. So, just paraphrasing, those in power should have complete transparency. Those who have no power other than their own power of their own family, their own lives, their own well-being, their own liberty, have to have complete 100% privacy. My take. That was a long one. Oh my God. This is a coconut. You can't really taste the coconut. I'm gonna put the coconut in this way. Okay. Actually, no, let's put it in the same way. No, this one. Because this I can't tell from the regular one. Let's put this guy here. Let's see how the raisins are. I'm missing a lot of conversation, gang. Sorry about that. This raisin one looks good. While we wait for the raisin one, I've got a few minutes. I'm gonna eat the coconut one, but I'm gonna eat it with, what should I eat it with? I wanna eat it with honey. I got a bunch of jams here that I've made. I'm gonna try them out. They're all, basically, we ate a lot of jams, so we took it easy. And, what do you call it? So we haven't been cracking open some of the jams. So I wanna crack open some of the jams, but I'm gonna, here's our honey. This used to be liquid. It's from the same batch of people. I'm just gonna put this on the side here. Actually, I wanna put a little extra for other stuff as well. And just use the honey and just dip it in there. This is cool enough, I can just go like this. Yeah, you can't taste the coconut. Interesting. Look at that. You can taste a little bit. This is good. This is definitely satisfying my craving of donuts. This is almost ready. Let's do chocolate. Chocolate chip. Chocolate chip. I don't know what this is gonna be like. We should do banana too. Banana would be really good. You know what? Before we do chocolate chip, let's do a banana. Because, oh, I put the chocolate chip in this. Okay, chocolate chip it is, right? So I'm just gonna do the dough from here. Let's mix this guy up. All right, let's take a look. And the chocolate chips are on the bottom there. So I'm gonna mix this up, see how. Let's see this. Oh yeah, this is definitely done. Cool. Left them in there a little too long. They're nice and crispy. Deep fried chocolate chip. The ancient ones would be they'd be like, what are you doing? My recipe. Let's check it out. And the next one we're gonna do banana. So let me use my fingers to eat this. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna read some comments. I'm way behind. I hope people are having good discussion on philosophy. Hi Tink, how are you doing? Yeah, for sure. They look like deep fried chicken, if that's what you're referring to. That's why I've been... We haven't done it yet, but what I want to do is get some chicken and cut them up into strips and dip them in this batter and make chicken strips with this. And I think it'll be doable. Maybe we'll do. Let's take it. Here's a little raisin. This raisin. And this raisin we can just put. Actually, let's sit here for a bit. Let's do this. The oil's decreasing a little bit, so they're sitting on the bottom of the pan, which we don't want. So I might make them a little smaller in the next one. Chicho, to what extent is the reason why I protect liberty? I think we want to not to distract from the philosophy, but man, those look good. They are. They're really tasty. They look to me like chicken, just eating, but still making me hungry. Everyone has a philosophy they are drawn to for me is a false. I gotta read him. Foucault, Michel Foucault, others, Plato, for Chicho, Robert Anton Wilson, yeah, and Bill Hicks. I challenge you all to find and share something you don't agree with from your favorite philosopher. Ah, that's a great challenge. That's a great challenge. I know there are stuff I don't agree with by Robert Anton Wilson and Bill Hicks, for sure. But I'll think about it. I'll think about it. Great question. Great question. Who was that? Index. Fantastic question. I'll try to come up with something from both of them while we're managing this. And for sure, we're going to do bananas that I don't think we're going to... Should we make them? Oh, we got the jam. Let me do the jam. This is... Check this one out. This is plum jam, right? Plum jam that I made... I guess we made. I don't know if this is I made or we made. From about 5 years ago. It's very liquid and we use it for pastries. There's a pastry dish that we make, which is super delicious. Okay. Oh, look at this. This is looking good, good. Nice. So let me put this in. Nicely sealed. Perfect. Let me show you this one. I'm gonna put. I ate all the coconut one. I was gonna put some of this on the coconut one. Oh well, we ate all of it. This is the raisin one, so I'm gonna put a little bit on this. Take a look at this. It's nice and liquid. So syrup with this thing would be amazing, right? So I'm gonna dump a little bit on this. I need another plate. Actually, I'll just put it on the lid of the jam. Perfect. Let's see what this tastes like. I can just pick it up. Dangerous, dangerous, dangerous. Oh, wow. This plum jam, I forgot how nice and tart it is. We use it for pastry because there's a pastry dish we make, and I'll show you one day. And it's like this thick, and on top of it, you put jam. It's amazing, right? And this is fantastic for that. Very good. Let me crack open this one. Raisin Armenian donuts. It's still hot, steaming. I'll do the little guy. Look at the color of the oil. It's changed. It's become darker because of the chocolate chips, I believe, anyway. The raisin was fantastic. Wow. Raisin one with the plum one, really good. Very good. The ancient ones were pleased with this one. Let's do it a little honey. Raisins and honey, why not? Malik, challenging accepted from Index, right? Socrates said that democracy was fundamentally flawed in that it was based on personal popularity. While I can believe in that overarching point, he believed it should be countered by requiring people to be qualified to vote. He never highlighted what those qualifications should be. Who should examine or certify those qualifications, leaving it open to corruption. or anything else. I felt this was ropey at the best and unrealistic. Yeah, I agree with that 100%. That's a serious flaw. By the way, Chicho, the pancakes you're making remind me of Dutch. Oof, oof. Oh, my hands are greasy, so I don't want to put on my glasses. Oliebulten. Dutch Oliebulten. Oliebulten. I think that's the way, maybe. I'm trying to do my German, but in the Dutch sense. To counter that, then, would you be... let's make sure this chocolate one before we read anymore. Oh, this is nice. Okay, this is done. Oh, yeah, there's a lot of chocolate. Stuck in the bottom of the... of the oil. Let's see. Okay, it's not stuck, but I can't get rid of it right now. What we're going to do is we're going to mush up banana. I know X, if you're still here, you wanted those banana pancakes. We're going to make Armenian banana donuts. Yes. I think you're a fan of bananas, so we'll do this. I love bananas. Bananas are it. I eat a lot of bananas. Okay, I'm gonna pop a little. So let's cut this up. This would be really good, I think. Might be a little too much, but why not? We'll make lots of banana pancake. Okay, that's good enough. So I need a spoon to grab these guys out of this. This should be something like the Vietnamese dish where they deep fry bananas, right? Battered bananas. And this would be amazing with chocolate as well. Chocolate and bananas? Oh my god. Maybe we'll do that. We'll do a couple of, because I put in enough for about three, I think, in this. So maybe with the third one, we'll make it chocolate worthy. Or with the second one, we'll make it chocolate worthy. So let's take this. Wait, what? That's large. Okay, let me kick the oil down a little bit. Let me transfer these guys. Hey, look. These guys in here. These look great. Never done this before. With all these goodies in there. Huh? Let's check this out. Oh, it looks like the chocolate in there is getting burnt. Sticking to the batter. It's okay. Get rid of it, it'll be less. Good enough. So Tink is saying, would you be okay with lowering the age to vote? And that everyone have a say, regardless of background. And Malik replied to that, it wouldn't be adverse to that. So Malik and Tink are talking, but I'm going to skip a few. Oh wow, there's so many comments here. Wow, wow, wow. Okay, I'm going to look for anything that says Chicho. Sorry if I missed a lot of conversations, people. I'm busy. Huh, from what way? Do that. I don't know that I can agree with you on the fact that you should prosecute or defame people for beliefs that may be perceived as harmful. Yeah, I don't think so at all. Yeah.
Oh, that's dangerous. Don't do it with one hand.
Gotta be quick on the tape with the oil, right? Societies. Malik, you should seize the means of donut production. I'm gonna read the shorter comments, I think. Sure, and now we have become. No, of course, let's see. Setting up a society based on what is currently a pipe dream seems like a doomed venture. And I'm just here for the donuts. I'm here for both. That was conquered. Conquering man, welcome to the donut party. Only problem is, only Chicho gets to eat any of them. Well, here's the positive and negative from both sides. If only Chicho gets a, only Chicho gets to eat them, but Chicho's gaining a little weight making all these cookies. So there's a downside to all of this eating as well. But I'm happy to be eating the donuts, that's for sure. I'm more of an optimist than a pessimist, I think, in regards to donuts. We should seize the means of donut production. I believe Bernie Sanders is a social democrat. He's pretty much the modern day FDR, is that? Not really. It definitely feels like Bernie Sanders has affected the perception of socialism. Careful, careful. Careful, careful.
Okay, we're definitely going to take down the heat on this.
See. The donut. Okay, cool. Way back down at the where the texts are coming in. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna make the rest of the banana. I'm gonna make the rest of the banana. I'm gonna put chocolate in this fucking cake. Take this. Fuck it. Can you add more? You should add more. I think this is the last batch we're gonna make for these guys.
Let's mix this up before we take the results.
Is that going to be enough? Chocolate chips. I'm going to add a little bit more chocolate chips.
Semi-sweet chocolate chips. I'm not using bittersweet, I'm using semi-sweet.
Okay, that's good. So let's get these guys out. Yes. separate these so they're drip drying nicely. Chocolate and banana. Okay, we're not gonna make any more mixes, so let's put that guy there. And dip this guy here. And the chocolate definitely affects the oil. Okay, so I still have batter here, but I think what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna wait till tomorrow and just make straight up pancakes and eat pancakes tomorrow. Okay. Because the batter you can keep for later, because I think this oil, the chocolate spilled into it. So I think next time if I end up making this way, which I will, because it's super delicious, the chocolate ones I'll do last, 100%, 100%. Cool. So, I'm gonna try the banana one. Well, we gotta take this one down first. You know what, let me crack open another one. This is. Blackberry, I think it's just straight up blackberry. It could be blackberry blueberry jam that we made. Okay. Nice. Check it out. Yeah, it could be just straight up blueberry. So I'm gonna try a little blueberry with this. Delicious. Very good. This could end badly. I think that this is blackberry jam. Put some more mayonnaise. No, it is. I sort of sort my stuff out in different places. That way I don't make a mistake. Try not to anyway. What do we got here? Let's pull this guy out. So, we want a banana. Banana. Check that out. Yeah. And there's something that we make, Russians make as well, and I will show you guys how we make that. It's called the pirashki, and it's basically this, but it's not pancake dough. It's dough that we make, and you take meat mix, and wrap it in there, and your Ukrainians have it, or Armenians have it, like Eastern Europeans have it, and you roll it up and you deep fry it, right? And this looks like those, but it's not, right? The banana squishy. Chicho, is this... YouTube was like, I actually working right now? These billboard chats don't make themselves. Caseman, donuts and discords. Say it. Chicho. Is this like dude making donuts at a mantra speakeasy while the rest of us are talking about contemporary philosophy? Mantra speakeasy. That's the first time I ever heard those two words together. Let's check out that. Oh, I like the banana. The banana's fantastic. Wow. The banana's really good. Tastes amazing. It doesn't even need anything. Any of the jams or anything. Mm-hmm. Let's try it out. This was the plum. The plum jam is amazing. Tart, so good. Montmartre is a region of France, of Paris, famous for loads of philosophers and artists hanging around there. Oh, really? I didn't know that. Mainly because it was poor and the drink was cheap and the police didn't really go there, so you could do what you like. Oh, really? That's cool. Free society. Talk philosophy. Or maybe the extremely well off do the same thing on the extremes, maybe. I don't know. Very good. I like the pancake. I like the banana. Still eating. Yeah. Could you make those with a filling inside? You know what? I guess this is filling inside. I'm mixing it all together. It's cooking together. So on the, it's hitting it on the outside as well, of course. But for the filling inside, the dough is not strong enough to fill it up and roll it up. It's just like pancake batter. There is a dough that we make to make filling, like what you're talking about, like basically deep fried dough on the outside and something on the inside. There is something we have like that. And Russians have it, Ukrainians have it. And it's like deep fried version of pierogies, but bigger and puffier. Very good. It's hot. The Soviet Russia. The dough fills you. That's funny. That was very yummy. The banana is a serious hit. Very delicious. Here's the banana one. Right. Here's a little crunchy one. Take that out. Good, good. This is chocolate banana. Oh, the bottom's sticking to the pan, right? It's not floating anymore. Yeah, this is definitely the last one we'll make. Okay.
I do have more batter from now.
We're not gonna make it. We'll do, whatchamacallit. How are we doing for time anyway? It's around 40. Banana cakes. I propose you name them banana cakes. How about deep fried banana cakes? There's gotta be deep fried in there. It just can't be banana cakes because it could be confused with banana pancakes. Cookies of the ancient. You can go in the tone alongside cookies of the ancients. Is this some popular food in Armenia? It's not. It's our family recipe. It's just basically we started doing it within our homes when we were kids. My mom used to make. You just take pancake dough, and here's the recipe, by the way. Let me show you this. No, where is it? There it is. So here's the recipe, right? So it's a little different than the pancake dough. We made a video of talking about philosophy and pancakes, and that was the pancake dough. I don't have that up right now, but this is sort of a modification of that. And you need it to be a little bit harder just to stay
contained, right? The regular pancake, though, you can make it more liquidy because it flattens out and flipping and stuff. This one, you need it to be a little bit more contained. If you do it really loose, then it just totally breaks apart in the oil, and you don't want that. So that's the recipe we have, and it's something that my mom, our family, used to make, or makes. And my mom's a little bit different. Hers, I actually brought a plastic bag here because I couldn't find my squisher thingamajiggy. But I was gonna do this, pour it in here and then cut the bottom. But you can take the squisher thing and just go like this, and it comes out all like pipey and stuff like this. It's pretty good. It just gets more fried. So it's just something that our family made, and we started giving it to my cousins and stuff, and they started calling, you know, when they came over, they would say, hey, you know, to our family, they would say, can you make Armenian donuts, and they referred to this, right? So that's what we're doing. That's why calling them Armenian donuts. A couple minutes more. So this is what we got so far. Check it out. This is the loot so far. Right? We got a regular one. This is a regular one. This is raisin. This is banana. This one is... Did I even try a chocolate one? Straight up chocolate? I think so. I don't think I tried a chocolate. These two are chocolate. I didn't try a straight up chocolate, but we'll try a chocolate banana. So we're gonna have two more, and I gotta, you know, just for that recipe, this is how much dough is left. And this will, you know, I'm gonna add a little bit more yogurt honey mix to this to make it more liquidy. Take a look. You can make pancakes with this as well, but it's a little bit on the harder side, right? I'll loosen this up, right? I'll loosen this up tomorrow because this is going to get a little bit more harder in the fridge. Just keep it in the fridge, loosen it up with yogurt and water. And then that'll give me about probably three, four smaller size pancakes, right? So with this recipe, we got, I don't know how many of these things I've eaten, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10 of these guys, and you can get three pancakes, right? That's enough to fill enough breakfast for 3 or 4 people, right? Enough breakfast. A spot of tea. Hello, hello. Welcome, welcome. Dictatorship of the donuts. In your sources for political and economic news video, you mentioned that you follow Laura Flanders, Chris Hedges, and Noam Chomsky. Personally, they are some of my favorite leftist political commentators, for sure. Those three, Laura Flanders is straight up, man. I'm going to take the recipe down. Laura Flanders is straight up. I like that lady. She's, you know, I don't agree with everything all of these people say. I really don't. And going back to Casey's, well, no, we won't go there. There's a question. Find something wrong with some of the people. I'm going to turn the oil off. Some of the people you follow. I know there's one thing I 100% disagree with Chris Hedges. With Noam Chomsky, I disagree with, you know, things I know that I disagree with Noam Chomsky. Laura Flanders, I disagree with her on certain things, but man, she is such a likable, fantastic person. It's hard to, like, not like her. It really, really, very, I like her. Just sincere and honest. Dictator of the donut crits. Whoops. I only just remembered about this stream. How much have I missed? You missed. Chicho eating like 4 of these guys. There are different types of donut filled things, right? Like, for example, this one is chocolate filled. Let's see if you can see it. That's chocolate filled. This is a banana, not filled, it's just mixed in, right? This is banana. I ate one banana. I think I forgot to eat a chocolate. Here's just straight up. And then this one is raisin.
Hayden Raisin. This one is raisin, and there's another chocolate down there. And we got two of these guys. This is chocolate banana. So good, so good. Right now, my favorite, I think, just eating straight out, the chocolate, the banana one was really good. So I'm really looking forward to trying the chocolate banana one, but I have to let it cool down a little bit. Jordan Peterson, let's make sure I'm talking about the same person. Jordan Peterson is a university professor from Toronto, I believe, isn't it? Oops. That's Jordan Peterson. Peterson, it has to be. But there's so many names that have come out right now that, yeah, Jordan Peterson. I just want to make sure that I'm referenced in person. Yeah, I like Jordan Peterson. I don't agree with everything he says. I really don't. But he's straight up. I mean, he's come out and straight up told people, look, man, the world cannot function in safe spaces. You can't ask the world to bend to your offensiveness or how easily you get offended, right? You can't force your opinion on others because you feel like you're being offended because someone's giving you their opinion or that's the way they choose to live. I like him. I like him on that level for sure. You've missed the hardcore philosophy chat. Yeah, and there's a lot, and Spot of Tea, there's been a lot of great philosophy chat, a lot of great info. I learned a fair bit from this stream, which is fantastic. Thank you very much, everyone. I love this. This is, I did my stint as a, for sure, I don't know, Canada is the way it works to a certain degree. Some people, I did your stint as a barfly for a while, right? And there's a lot of philosophy talk in barfly world. Most of it not coherent, so this is way more coherent with reference stuff, right? You missed hardcore philosophical chat. We're now on to donut communism buns. That's brilliant. Better put those donuts in the fridge. Better put those donuts in the fridge. They could go stand at room temperature. We actually solved all problems, economic, political, and philosophical. Why communism puns? I have no idea. We go talking about Marxism, Marxist philosophy, and it turned into donut, I can't even pronounce that, and seizing the means of donut production. How about Jordan Peterson just described? Just subscribe to the Land of Friends podcast. Thanks for the recommendation. My pleasure. I hope you enjoy. I don't listen to everything she says, and I go through periods where I don't check her out, like for weeks or a couple of months or something, and then I go back and skim through and get a feel of what she's presenting. It's just getting the feel for it. And I definitely don't agree with everyone she interviews, 100%, right? Some of those people I disagree with 100%. Nothing's 100%, but I disagree with some of the core philosophies that they're presenting. But it's information, and it's good information coming to you in a pleasant manner. They look really good. Yeah, these are really good. These little things. I took a family recipe and modified it a little bit, and added the ingredients, so they're delicious. This question might be a bit off topic, but what are some of your favorite heavy metal bands? Favorite heavy metal bands? System of a Down. Right, Tool, Iron Maiden, I went off on a long time ago. I liked Saxon when they had a little stint. Saxon was good. Boston, if you can consider them to be Boston, you know, heavy metal. Slayer, I've gone off on a little bit, not enough. Dillinger Escape Plan, Mathcore, I like Mathcore right now. Gorija from France, fantastic. Right, Sepultura from Brazil, fantastic, fantastic. I went and saw them here. It wasn't the original band, but fantastic. Those are some of the metal bands I like, just the top of my head, right? So that's Yu Hakusho asked about the metal. Yes, Peterson is a victim of many of his. Whoops. I'm missing one. Peter's is a victim of his followers who actually espouse some pretty stupid beliefs that he himself does not hold, but is regularly asked to defend. Yeah, I don't follow his followers. I don't, you know, I saw an interview of him with the US broadcaster. That was the lady. That was hilarious. She was, you know what, I'm only gonna eat half of this one, the chocolate banana one. There's a fair bit. So let me see if I can cut this without burning myself. Let me take this. I'm gonna squish this out. There we go. Nice. Yeah, and that was crazy. Ideas, principles get hijacked and taken over. Unfortunate. But his take on personal responsibility and living in such a way as to make your immediate surroundings a little bit better, awesome. Yeah, personal responsibility, that's the key, man. You can't force your opinions on others, force others to change because of you. If you don't like a surrounding, move along. If you like a surrounding, adjust to learn and grow and possibly contribute to that surrounding. Awesome. People are too sensitive. Need to grow thicker skin, I think, in my opinion. Having just subscribed to Laura Flanders, can anyone recommend some good podcasts? I recommended Philosophies, this topic. You know what? Laura Flanders jumps around everywhere. So, other than Laura Flanders, good podcasts. Other than Laura Flanders, I like the Richie Allen show. I visit the Richie Allen show every now and then. He got kicked off of YouTube and he's back on YouTube again. I don't agree with everything Richie Allen has to say or his guests, but I like the passion there. I don't agree with his I don't agree with his fiscal views, but he's obviously very well read and worth listening to on issues of psychology and sociology. Even if you don't agree with him, the total rejection and attempts to not allow him to speak at all seems a bit silly. 100% July. I actually played session drums for Dillinger Escape. You did? Oh man. After their original drummer left them to join another band. Yeah, Dillinger Escape Plan's fantastic. I just Miss Machine and Calculating Infinity. Wow, man. I looped those two albums so much. It's a symphony of brilliance just coming at you. It is absolutely fantastic. And I've seen them twice live. And I discovered Animals as Leaders through Dillinger Escape Plan, but I think the second time they came around, Animals as Leaders was the first band that was opening up for them, right? Fantastic, man. That must have been a brilliant. What was the, who did the other drummer band join? Dillinger Escape Plan has one of the greatest drummers I have ever seen. That guy is an animal. Yeah, they're pretty good, man. Dillinger Escape Plan is fantastic. What I tell people usually is the best drummers, guitarists, and bassists in the world play metal. I'm being too absolute about this, but there's some amazing metal that's technically just blows you away. It was bloody hard. Yeah, I bet. Da, 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 da. Oh, was that Malik? Oh, Malik, you played session drummer for Dillinger Escape Plan. Oh my god, that's cool, man. That's very cool. Gorgia are amazing. Yeah, I saw Gorgia live. Gorgia live was wow, man. I lucked out, I got a ticket. They came into, and Gorgia was opening for Slayer, and Slayer was playing in Seattle, okay? And Slayer was skipping Vancouver. I think it was Slayer. Slayer was skipping Vancouver. They were going directly to Calgary. Gorgia knew they had a fan base in Vancouver, so they came to Vancouver to play one night, to go to the next night to play in Calgary, because it was one day downtime, right? So they rented a club downtown Vancouver, Granville Street. It's just mainstream club, it's not metal place, right? So we went there, the place was packed, And there was a couple of bands playing beforehand. It was okay, it wasn't bad. And then when Gorgeous was coming on, everyone went on the dance floor, and I was on the dance floor as well, right? I'll tell you guys about what do you call it? Slamming. I like the physical contact, right? So I was on the dance floor, and there was people there with cups of beer, holding cups of beer or drinks. They had no idea what is about to happen, right? So Gorgia comes on, and they go, boom, and all of a sudden, the dance floor, the 80% of us that were like Gorgia fans just went, and those people were holding their drinks. They were like frailing. Their drinks are going like this. It was a fun time, man. Gorgia, I highly recommend. Fantastic band. Fantastic band. So fun. So fun. Slayer is one I could never get behind for some reason. Dillinger is fantastic, though. Slayer, I've listened to a little bit. I don't know their music very well. And since metal has come up, Metallica I listened to for a while, right? And then I was one of the 300,000 people that got an email from them back in 1999 or something like this, from their lawyer saying they're gonna sue me for sharing their music online, right? So I just laughed at this, right? I think it was around 1999 or something like this. I just laughed at this and downloaded everything and shared everything, right? But then when I went to listen to Metallica, every time I went to listen to them, I couldn't finish a song because they just betrayed their fan base. They just betrayed their core philosophy, right? They went after money, right? They sent me a letter to cease and desist sharing their music, something that I loved. I was like, man. So after a month of trying to listen to them again, I couldn't listen to them. So I deleted all their music and stopped sharing their music. That's one of the reasons Lars came out and apologized to the world, to his fan base, saying, oh, I'm sorry, he wasn't sincere about it. If he was sincere about it, he would have taken a little bit of his money, right, and given it to people to defend them for sharing content, right? So I still don't listen to Metallica. That's one thing. Chocolate banana, thumbs up. Thumbs up. Let's check this out. It's amazing. Yeah, everyone's amazed that Malik was a session drummer for it was fun. They did all their auditioning in the States, but Chris P basically quit the band mid-tour, and they were in the UK. I think he joined Coheed. I don't know Coheed. Coheed and Cambi. Okay, I'll try to download that. Or I'll try to find their music. Whoa, yeah, I missed that. That's insane, Malik. I heard Tool is coming out with someone mentioned this before too in a previous stream, that Tool's coming out again after 12 long, it's been 12 years. That was 12 years ago I saw them live. Wow. Yeah, that would have been 12 years ago. That's a long time ago, man. Tool's brilliant. Was just gonna ask him if his checked out Coheed. No, I haven't. I'll definitely check him out. Saw them live last year. They put out an absolute best show live ever since, right beside Slipknot. Oh yeah, Slipknot and Manson. Oh, I never saw Manson. I never got into Manson. I gotta write this. You know what? I'll try to remember to write this down. I don't have my pad with me right now. Da-da-da. The problem I find with most philosophical types that are reaching public face these days is that often people tend to glean specific things from topics that they personally attach to. Most often they have a personal reason behind those attachments. Yeah, it becomes an echo chamber. That's what I found out too. Attachment, and feel passionately inclined to translate them to others in their own words. Yeah, they become disciples, like born again Christian movements and stuff like this. Often this creates a telephone game effect and completely distorts the original work. 100% agree. I think a lot of, yeah, that happens with, I mean, take organized religion, right? what might want to check out a UK band called Sicketh. I don't know Sicketh. I'll look into them too. So there's a couple of bands. I gotta write this down. Where is a pad here? Nice. Let's check out the other one. Coheed. Thank you very much for the recommendations, people. Da, 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 da. Hi, Diggy. How you doing, Diggy 128? And on the lighter side, a Japanese band called Mouse on the Keys. Mouse on the Keys. Oops. Mouse on the Keys. Always take recommendations from a session drummer for Dillinger Escape Plan. I'm pretty sure you might know this, Malik. I had a drum set too. I played a little bit of drums, but mine was nothing on this level. Nothing on this level. Has one of the best contemporary drummers in the world, really. Akira Kiyosaki, a lovely man too.
This is a gold mine.
Akira. That's the drummer for Mouse on the Keys. Oh, I'll remember this. Drummer. I'm just going to put drummer here. Drummer. Look it up. Are you a professional drummer? I think Malik is for sure. It's the nature of social media at the moment. As people are sort of ring fencing themselves in little boxes and echo chambers is actually one thing that is being pointed out from both sides of the political divide by many sources, that if you are afraid to be challenged or to debate, you get philosophically stuck in one place and are unable to grow or learn. 100%. Bruce Lee was paraphrasing someone saying that flow, the whole thing with flow with water, like water, right? I was semi-pro. The money was never enough to fully support me. Oh, that's unfortunate. I wish it was. I wish there was. I work in the music industry. It's really, really hard. Marketing is more important than talent anymore. I think that's been the case for a very long time when it comes to the music industry, no? It's, I mean, look at the band that came out, the Three Brothers Black. That came out, that it was only later on that the album was called it was a Detroit Three Brothers Detroit metal band, and then they made a documentary after the album became really popular, and they were political and they were very good, but they, man, that documentary made me sad. What was it called? The band was called Black, but I forget what the album was called. Die, I think Die something. Make it more important than not. I work in the music. Da, 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 da. Yes, I agree with that. Though I always find personal challenge to comments as a default. The defensive nature is sure. Often Rich Bros allows me to realize a fault and try to correct the course and improve. That is great teacher. When was it different? When was it different? Yeah, that's true. The digital revolution changed everything. It's all about streaming now, and streaming does not pay. Well, I'm hoping it does at some point. I'd like to do this full time. I'd like to create the math content full time, provide math. But there has to be a business plan behind it, and I do have some kind of business plan anyway. Enjoy the process anyway. I met Lars in late 93, insecure in a pretty good description. That's Lars from Metallica. I would have done the same. That. You know what? Let me turn off these extra screens because we're done with these extra cameras. Depp, weren't looking for a new drummer at the time. Dillinger Escape Plan, they weren't looking for a new drummer at the time. They just wanted someone who knew their songs to keep them sharp during a few practices while they had a 3-day layover in Scotland to allow their stand-in to be flown out to meet their tour requirements. Wow. So 3 days, they didn't want 3 days of downtime. That's how intricate the music is. They didn't want 3 days of downtime to become rusty at it. Brilliant. That must have been fun, man. So difficult. The best philosophy is the basis of all philosophy. The best philosophy is the basis of all philosophy, except that you do not know anything and need to keep learning. That way you remain always open to new ideas and innovations that can update your thinking. Also, if your beliefs are never tested in the fire of debate, how can you ever possibly know if they're worth the paper they're printed on? Agreed. Great point, Malik. Coheed and Cambria is the full name. Coheed and Cambria. Okay, Coheed and Cambria. Thank you very much for that. Where to go? Cambria. Coheed and Cambria. Thank you very much for that, Big. Personally, I'm not a fan of Jordan Peterson. I find Peterson and Ben Shafire to be a bit intellectually dishonest. On the issues of free speech, I feel a bit mixed. I definitely support reasonable, rational, respectful, ideological debate. You know what? Who decides if something is reasonable or rational? Even irrational debate is worth listening to, right? You can pick it apart. There might be a certain amount of truth in there. Respectful? Maybe. However, for some people, that's the tea. Okay, we're gonna turn off the tea as well. People, let's check it out. However, for some people out there who have experienced very traumatic and horrifying experiences, they may feel apprehensive about engaging in a fierce debate. Then they shouldn't. That's the reason why we have counselors and therapists who they can share their experiences with. Yeah, I agree with that. Actually, branching into your love for comic books, Coheed and Cambria has their own comic. Oh, really? That tells the backstory they made behind the band. And oh, I didn't. Cool. I wrote this down. Comic. And Neil Peart actually put out a comic. I still don't have it. The drummer for Rush. I forget what it's called. Actually, branching into your there we go. Music. Thank you very much for that, Big. My favorite example of marketing over talent is Bon Jovi. No kidding. They're about to be introduced Rock and Roll. Oh my God. John Bon Jovi may not be the best writer of musicians of all time, but he's a hell of a businessman, most definitely. And he has a voice, right? He belted it out. That was during the glam rock days, I guess. I agree with your comment to me. Malik, I am a lifelong learner with no formal education to support it. This allows me to, that's probably a good thing, possibly. This allows me to not only accept that I do not know everything, but reinforce it with a lack of credentials to learn on when confronted with alternative points of view, thinking, not to mention, I'm regretful. Yeah, I may have misspoken that marketing is more important. Yeah, that's regarding Caseman, music industry. Might just be that. I haven't seen that much of Jordan Peterson, but I get somewhat of an impression that he panders to his audience. Well, he commented regarding that. He said he's huge on YouTube, and YouTube, I think, I don't know the stats, I'm paraphrasing, taking Jordan Peterson's word for it, not the exact number, but I think he said 80% of YouTube is male. So that's his audience. I think Shapiro in particular could be described as a sophist, someone who is more concerned with sounding plausible than actually seeking knowledge. Shapiro, Which one is Shapiro? Stuart Shapiro? I don't think I know Stuart Shapiro. I have to see their face. I don't think I've seen this guy very often. I'm not familiar with him. Interesting. It may not be worthwhile. Trust Malik more than Shapiro. Or the internet, if they call him philosopher. I am fundamentally suspicious of anyone who comes to me preaching an absolute political or philosophical truth or certainty. I tend more towards people who present such things as part of a wide array of equally worthwhile ideas which suit different places in the policy landscape. Amen to that, Malik. Amen to that, Caseman says. I understand that the people can find debate difficult, but I believe that comes from a system that teaches them that being right in the moment is more important than learning and growing as you go. Try not to see debate and discussion as being about winning or beating the other person round to your point of view. Think of it as sharing information so that everyone learns. Awesome. Awesome, Malik. 100% agree. And that's a great place to call this philosophy debate done. I think that's fantastic. Ben Shapiro. Oh, Ben Shapiro. I know the name, Ben Shapiro. Let me look up Ben Shapiro. But I really wanted to end there. Malik put on another comment. I've heard the name Ben Shapiro. Let's check this out. Ding, ding. Yeah, I've heard the name, but I don't know this guy. I don't listen to this guy. He is a right-wing political okay. There's a lot of flaws in right-wing and left-wing. As soon as they take the two extreme views, they're not even two extremes. They're center extremes, right? The extremes go further, and some of the other extremes further out are better than these ones. These ones are just pandering to their audience. As you've said before, there's nothing wrong with listening to what he says, but you quickly find that his statements are more to do with generating heat and promotion of his money-making events than enlightening anyone. Yeah, there's a lot of those people around, right? Agreed. His money-making schemes relies on the political divide to survive. Yeah, many people do. Politics and economics. Politics as product marketing. Da-da-da-da. That really is a great perspective on debates. I hope to see that world that can accept that view, as it would help us all. And that goes back to where we said, well, just read Malik's last sentence. Think of it being debate. Think of debate as sharing information so that everyone learns. Can't argue with that. There is no debate there. That's just straight up fact, or maybe complete fact, right? Using Ra's maybe logic and some of the other people, there is no absolutes. Thank you very much for being here, everyone. That was fun. And I'm proud of these guys. Look at this. Nice stuff. This is good. Got my snacks for the day. I got too many pastries. I'm gonna take some of this stuff to the ancients and show them what I've made. Can't eat all this. I still have Brussels sprouts left, so I'm gonna be munching on those. So let's see. Announcement comic books. Today, 3:30 p.m. we're gonna look at the comic books, right? And I'm gonna bring up some comics I've been reading, buying, stacking, so I can read later, and some of the series that I'm keeping up with, right? So I'm going to show you my pull list, some of my reads, the series I'm continuing. I'm trying to stay up with anyway. I'm way behind. The streaming just took over my life, right? So I'm way behind on my comic book reads, right? And a lot of reads, really. But that's what we're going to do today at 3:30 p.m. Thank you, everyone. Thanks for the discussion and the donuts, everyone. For sure. Thank you, Malik. Really is great perspective. That absolutely is kind of similar to how so many right wingers all against feminism and that. Thanks everyone. Thank you guys. Thank you guys. Thank everyone for sure. Oh, by the way, Chicho, did you set up a Discord? I did set up a Discord. Did I set it up here? You know what? In the next stream at 3:30, I set it up. I'm not sure how to use it. Like, I know you can do chats there and stuff. But where's my Discord? Where's my Discord? Is it here? Oh, I did it on the other computer, so I don't have the link here. I should provide it. You know what I'll do? I'll provide the Discord link in, if you scroll down where all the info is regarding the channel, where it's, you know, it has the now live, about page, support, you know, PayPal, Patreon, crypto. I'll add the Discord link in there. Okay, so I'll do that before the next stream. That way it's there. And then I guess slowly I'm going to learn how to use Discord as well. It's more of a open place. Thank you for recommending that, by the way, Tom. It was really easy to set up. But I have to learn the platform. I don't know the platform well. Comrades, seize the means of donut production. Down with the bourgeoisie. I got my first run of comics just yesterday. The Black Monday Murders feels good. Oh, Black Monday. I picked up the first few. I dropped it because I wasn't reading it, right? But it was brilliant. There's some brilliant comics out there, right? Brilliant comics out there. Thanks for the fun, Chicho. My pleasure. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Awesome stream. Fantastic. Thank you for sharing, everyone. Very nice feel to this channel. Oh, thank you. Thank you very much for the compliment, man. Thank you very much for the compliment. Thank you for participating. I'll see you guys 3:30 if you can make it. If you can't, the next streams are going to be about a week out, I believe. I might do a couple of pop-ins here and there, okay? Bye for now. We'll talk later.